Today, I've got some awesome tricks that are going to show you how to use copy, paste, and flip with Tinkercad Sketch Tools. So let's get cracking. To make this quicker, we are going to start with a bit.ly. You can type bit.ly/fish clip and press enter. So this is my magnetic fish template, but we're going to use it to make a chip clip. If you want to complete that tutorial, it's right here. Now, of course, it's set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad: give a reaction before you copy and tinker. When you use copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of my project. This was the part that we built. This shows you can ungroup and explore it. I added a note here saying thanks for checking it out. Here is how you would find the Tink Jaws tutorial. Now I'll also put today's tutorial in here as well, and then these are just bonus tutorials you can check out. So real quickly, this is what we're building. It is a clip that when you squeeze the back, the jaws open. It uses this little spring right here, and this piece is the awesome cutout that makes it so it all works after we group it. I'll just show you these. Control G is a union group. This says that opening. These jaws are separate, and it should make sense that if you squeeze, it'll open. Now we're remaking this tutorial because now we've got the ability to mirror and copy our parts. Check this out. To make this so it lines up better, we're going to grab this part and we want to get the center of this circle as close to one of these lines as we can. So you can see if I do one click over, that looks like the circle is pretty much centered and we definitely have it on the middle of the design this way. Now when we grab the sketch tool, we're going to set it in this 20 by 20 square. When you do this, it lines it up so that when we get inside, bingo, it is centered. That makes the rest of this project much easier. Now, if you've never used Sketch before, make sure you check out the Sketch features. There are 5 different pages, awesome animations. This gets updated all the time, so make sure you check back every once in a while. The features here are super cool. When you're done checking them out, you can simply hit continue to sketch and you're back to work. If you prefer my tutorials, I've got a playlist with all of them. I'll put them in the cards or you could use this bit.ly. Now today we're gonna start by building the circle that goes around our shape. Notice I went 2 millimeters past, 2 millimeters past, once again, 2 millimeters past, and I'm just clicking and making these points. I'm going to come out here. This one looks like 2 millimeters past and 2 millimeters past. If you miss by one, you can double click to edit, click on the point and just nudge it to where it needs to be. Once you've got it how you want, you can double click and it auto smooths. Now we do want to change this front. We're going to do that by adding points. If you press number 4, you're in add point mode. You can click and add the 4 points we need. Now you do need to hit V so that you can move these. Otherwise, you'll delete them and have to re-add them. And then we simply want to take these middle ones and move them back. Now, as you're trying to move these, if you can't get around the dimensions, you can hide them just like this. Zoom in, and we just want to make these straight and come back through half of this shape. So it's past half. Now we can click on these, and instead of the curves, we can hit it with a number 1, so it's a straight line, and a number 1, so it's a straight line. I'm going to click on this and just use the down arrow so that it stays perpendicular. We can change the nudges to 0.1 to make it even more accurate. Bang! That is the opening for our part. We had to get inside this area because it's what's going to cut out a little bit later. Next up, we're going to draw the part we squeeze. I'm going to pan by pushing in my mouse scroll wheel, although if you're still editing, we do need to double click. Now hit P for pen, and we just want to start somewhere back here, and we're going to switch to Bezier curve. Press number 2, go past it, and click, hold, and twist so that it's got a nifty bend. I'm going to move up about 2 millimeters past, click, and then I'm going to do the click, hold, and twist to bend this down a little bit. And then I'm going to finish it with a straight line by hitting number 1 and connecting it like that. Double click, click on your points, and get them so they look exactly how you want. I think that's kind of interesting. I'm going to drag this point back here. Notice right now these are smooth curves. If you hit number 3, they are broken handles. That way you can adjust each of them independently. And as I showed you earlier, at any time, you can click on anything and hit number 1 to make it align. Of course, if you don't like what you did, you can do Control Z. All right, so this shape makes me happy. I'm gonna double click to finish it and do Control C and Control V to make a copy. I'm gonna use the nudge or shift nudge to move it back so it matches the other side. Now I'm gonna do shift nudge to move it below. And then here's the cool part. Make sure you've got your dimensions on. See this 5.34? I wanna flip it this way. I'm gonna just take that number, and yours will be different because we each drew our own. And when I make it negative, bang, it flips. I can do shift nudge to pull it down. I wanna get it right to that edge. And just like that, the squeeze part is complete. All right, let's do the same thing for the jaws. P for pen. I'm going up 2 millimeters in. I'm gonna just click and I'm gonna come down to this center line. Now I'm gonna go up. I'm gonna change my nudge to 0.5, just makes this a little easier to snap. And down. Dimensions are in the way so we can hide those again. And up and down. If you miss, you can adjust it later. That'll be the one I do want. And down, and then let's end this. I'm gonna press number 2 for a bezier curve. And I want it to have a bent end. So I'm click, hold, and twist to get that out there, and then connect this back. Now we can double click to make it perfect. I'm gonna take this point and I'm gonna just use the arrow keys to nudge it down. I like that. I think I want this to be number 1, which is a straight line. And then I'm gonna just adjust this curve a little bit until I'm happy. Once we are happy, double click to finish, bring back our dimensions, Control C and Control V. I'm gonna do the nudge to get it to the exact spot. And then we just need to flip it. Once again, we wanna flip this one vertically. So we're gonna do -3 or whatever your number is, and then nudge it into place. Now we do want them to be at opposite points. All right, so real quickly, let's double click and edit this. Notice that point I forgot to fix. I should have done that before I duplicated, but it only takes a moment to click on them and adjust them as it is. I will show you quickly, if you ever double click, it auto straightens, and if you double click again, it auto smooths. I don't want either of those, so I'm just gonna use Control Z to back up. I'm gonna double click to finish that one, and I do wanna get this one down to this line so they meet just like that. If you wanna make them look a little different, so maybe the clips stretch all the way out, you can adjust it. Once you're done, you simply hit finish sketch. I'm gonna take this one's thickness and I'm gonna set it to 8. You can adjust this for how strong you want these to be. The more plastic you have, the stronger. And then we just need to bring this one through. And when you do Control G and group, you have just built a fantastic clip that prints relatively fast. Notice when I brought the sketch out, I set it on top of that shape. So we do need to hit D to drop. And then this is how you send it for 3D printing. I'm exporting just the selected shape as an STL. I like to save it in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm just gonna call it new clip and hit save. We're gonna print it on the Bamboo Labs P1S. I'm gonna hit create brand new project. Let's add that file. Of course, it's in 3D modeling. There's the words new clip, and let's bring it in. I'm gonna print it with some zero PLA. I'm gonna stay with the standard 0.2 settings and let's hit slice plate. As you can see, 15 minutes and let's hit print plate. And finally, send it to the 3D printer. And just a little bit later, we have got an awesome clip. How cool is that? And check it out, I do want to highlight, of course, this is the clip we just made. There are also variations. We've got the cool sketch gator, and we've got what we call the tinker bug. Of course, you can also check out all my flexi projects and the brand new pumpkin cookie fidget. How cool is that? All right, so a quick review. This project we did earlier, but back then we had to draw each side separately. I figured sharing how we can copy, paste, and flip our sketches in the same design, it was worth taking a minute to show you. Friends, I do want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. A huge shout out as well to everybody that is part of my Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We are past 250 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, get support, and gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time that you like, hype, or share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.